Photosynthesis in higher plants. The plants synthesize food material by the process of photosynthesis. The photosynthesis include light phases as well as dark phases. During the light phase, assimilation energy is produced. The assimilation energy is ATP and NADPH. They are released in light phase. In dark reactions, carbon dioxide fixation or carbon assimilation is carried out. It is different in different plants. It is classified as two types based on the first formed intermediate compound. If it is consisting three carbon molecule, the plants are said as C3 plants, and the intermediate compound formed during the dark phase, if it is four molecules of carbon compound, the plants are said as C4 plants. It means based on the first stable intermediate compound, based on that, the plants are divided into two plants, two types, C3 plants and C4 plants. C3 plants carried the C3 cycle. The C3 cycle proposed by the scientist Melvin Kelvin. And in previous classes, we studied the C3 cycle. So, in the C3 cycle, basically three major steps. One is carboxylation, another one is reduction and regeneration of RUBP. There, the glucose molecule is produced. The produced exose sugar is transmitted into the cytoplasm for the metabolic reactions. There is a regeneration for the RUBP also. So, that included in C3 cycle. But you are coming to the C4 cycle. The C4 cycle is done into the plant which are live in high temperature. It means the plants which are present in tropical and subtropical temperature regions, they go on to high temperature, approximately 30 to 45 degrees of temperature. At that temperature, the plants survive. For their survivance, they go for the C4 cycle. What is C4 cycle? C4 cycle is nothing but of, it is a carbon fixation and also carbon assimilation. The first intermediate compound formed here is 4 carbon molecule consisting compound, that is OAA, oxaloacetic acid. So, the steps included in C4 cycle are given by two scientists, Hutch and Slock. That is why the cycle is called as a Hutchinson pathway. And here, carboxylation reactions are carried out. Hence, it is called beta carboxylation. Beta carboxylation cycle also. Cycle. Professor C.V. Ramadas belongs to India. He conducted experiments on C4 plants extensively. C4 cycle is first discovered in sugarcane plant. How they are differentiated from the C3 plants? You see, in the C3 plants, the dark reactions are carried out at stroma of chloroplast. The chloroplast are present in mesophyll cells of leaves. It means the location of dark phase in C3 cycle is stroma. It means single type of the chloroplast is involved in dark phase. But you see in C4 plants, the C4 plants show the dimorphism, chloroplast dimorphism. And the C4 cycle included in two cells of the plant. What are they? They are mesophyll cells as well as bundle sheath cells. So, this leaves are differentiated into two different types of cells, mesophyll cells and bundle sheath cells. Mesophyll cells are having the chloroplast, number of chloroplast. Here the RuBP carboxylase is absent. RuBP carboxylase enzyme is absent. Hence, here C3 cycle is not carried out. But in bundle sheath cells, the chloroplasts are present, but the chloroplasts are large sized chloroplast, there the grana is absent. It means agranulated chloroplasts are present in vascular bundle sheath cells. Here RuBP carboxylase is available. Here along with the C4 cycle, C3 cycle also carried out. So, you see here, compare with C3 and C4 cycle, in the C3 cycle only one PCR cycle is conducted, but in C4 cycle, along with C4 cycle, the C3 cycle also carried out. That's why photosynthetic yield wise, the C4 plants are more efficient than C3 plants. First, we see the leaf anatomy of the C4 plants. The leaf anatomy of the C4 plants are said as crunch anatomy. Crunch anatomy. Crunch anatomy means here, you see here, normally the leaves are having the epidermis, lower epidermis and upper dermis. The epidermal cells are present, like here also epidermal cells are present. Inside the mesophyll cells are present, the mesophyll cells. So, the mesophyll cells are rich with chloroplast. So, the number of chloroplasts are present, like you see here. And here the vascular bundles also present. So, they are very large, like vascular bundle sheath cells. Vascular bundle sheath cells. It means they have the large size of the chloroplasts. The chloroplast type is agranulated. Agranulated chloroplasts are present. And here, like, so these are the lower upper epidermis, lower epidermis, and these cells are mesophyll cells and these are bundle sheath cells. Bundle sheath cells, like the cells are present. So, the bundle sheath, this type of anatomy is called crunch anatomy. Crunch anatomy found in C4 plants. In these two cells, the C4 cycle is carried out in mesophyll cells and bundle sheath cells. The mesophyll cells are do not show the RuBP carboxylase. It means here the RuBP carboxylase is absent. Hence, here no possibility of C3 cycle. instead of RuBP carboxylase, PEP carboxylase is present. PEP carboxylase is present. The PEP carboxylase mediated the reaction, that is carboxylation reaction. So, here the first carbon dioxide acceptor is phosphoenol pyruvic acid. Phosphoenol pyruvic acid. So, that is PEP. In C3 cycle, the first carbon dioxide acceptor is RuBP, ribulose 1,5-bisphosphate, RuBP in C3 cycle. In C4 cycle, that is phosphoenol pyruvic acid, that is PEP. What is the compound formed in C3 cycle? In C3 cycle, the first stable compound is PG phosphoglyceric acid, PGA, which consisting 3 carbon molecule. But whereas in C4 plants, the first stable intermediate compound, that is oxaloacetic acid, oxaloacetic acid, that is OAA. How many carbons here? The 4 carbons. So, it is a 4 carbon compound. Hence, the cycle is right as C4 cycle. C4 cycle.